Dear WFTU members and friends all over the world, today it is a very important day for our family, for World Federation of Trade Unions. Today it is 3 of October 2021 and it is International Action Day of our forces. Today we celebrated the foundation of World Federation of Trade Unions from 3 of October 1945 in Paris and our struggles from 76 years already. We are proud and we honor the history and actions, the role, the strategic and tactic of World Federation of Trade Unions. Because always was, are, and will continue to be with the ordinary people, together with the people, for their rights, for their life. Today, this important day for us, we have with us very important cadres. First of all, we have with us Honorable Ambassador of Cuba in Athens, Comrade Zelmys. And thank you, dear Ambassador, because it is a pleasure for us to have with us to listen from your side about the Cuba, about the your initiatives, etc., etc. Also, we have with us our sister from Italy, from USB, Cinzia. Cinzia, she is a cadre of the USB, leadership of USB. Italy, it is very important country for Europe and not only for Europe, but all over the world. Also, USB, it is a class-oriented trade union movement, trade union in Italy, member of WFTU. And with us today, we have our comrade Pampis Kyritsis from Cyprus, General Secretary of PEO, also for many years, Vice President of World Federation of Trade Unions, with big experience. Babis was for many years member of the Cyprian Parliament, and it is a pleasure, honor for us that we are all together today here to celebrate together our important day. Thank you, dear Comrade Pampis. Dear comrades, as you know, on time we sent all of you our poster, our main slogans for today. Under the main slogan, dignified life. Dignified life. We choose this slogan because it is contemporary. It is a slogan for our times, for our struggles. We live in a period, crucial period, under the financial crisis, with poverty, unemployment, dismissals, problems for the working class, problems for the immigrants and refugees, privatizations, and from the other side, we show every day problems from the imperialist interventions. The last example, it was in Afghanistan, and it is in Afghanistan. 20 years, the imperialist forces, USA, NATO, and their allies, they were in Afghanistan for democracy. After 20 years democracy of imperialists, today chaos in Afghanistan, problems for the working class, the people of Afghanistan, and for all region, and not only for region. Also, in our times from imperialists, they have this anti-popular policy. They have the bloqueos, the sanctions against Cuba, against Venezuela, against Palestine, Syria, etc. We, as World Federation of Trade Unions, we need today also to have in our banners, our slogans, internationalist slogans, that we support each one of the people to decide for their present and their future. This right belongs to the people, not to, to the imperialists. Because of this, all together, we put all these demands after the common umbrella of a dignified life. This is the today means for us, and this is the today the means of dignified life. Brothers and sisters, dear colleagues all over the world, we salute all of you. Today, our family, it has 105 million members in 132 countries, and we are optimistic that through our struggles, we create better conditions for us, for our families, for the ordinary people, for the people all over the world. Because of this, we call upon all of you to have your initiatives inside in your workplaces, to have your efforts, your struggles, your activities, and through these activities, we are optimistic that we are going to unite our forces for the better today and better tomorrow. Now, allow me to give the floor to the ambassador of Cuba, Sister Zelmys, and we are ready to listen from you, your ideas and your view, dear comrade.
Muchas gracias, Mavrikos. Queríamos primero que todo dar gracias a la Federación Sindical Mundial por el honor de poder hablar en este importante evento sobre las consecuencias del bloqueo, las sanciones y discriminaciones a la vida digna del pueblo cubano. Muchas gracias por la amistad y apoyo permanente de la Federación Sindical Mundial al heroico pueblo de Cuba. Como saben, amigos, con la revolución de 1959, encabezada por Fidel Castro, fue cuando el pueblo cubano alcanzó su verdadera independencia. Comenzó a regir su propio destino y garantizó sus derechos y dignidad plenos. En estos 62 años de revolución, se ha podido medir la capacidad del pueblo de Cuba y sus líderes para levantar frente a la hostilidad feroz y sin tregua de los Estados Unidos las banderas de la dignidad, la libertad, la independencia, la soberanía, la unidad y la integración de América Latina y el Caribe, la democracia, el socialismo y la solidaridad con los pueblos del mundo. La clave de la victoria del pueblo cubano en estas 6 décadas de revolución ha sido la estrecha relación, la estrecha unidad del pueblo en torno a su vanguardia, el Partido Comunista, y al liderazgo de la revolución, lo cual sigue siendo imprescindible para llevar adelante la consolidación y profundización del proceso revolucionario cubano, para enfrentar el injusto y criminal bloqueo económico, comercial y financiero de los Estados Unidos contra Cuba y desarrollar el país en aras del bienestar del pueblo cubano. Luego de estos años de revolución socialista en Cuba, se pueden mostrar múltiples logros, como por ejemplo, se garantiza el cumplimiento del derecho a la salud gratuita, la educación gratuita y universal en todos los niveles de enseñanza, se garantiza el acceso a la cultura y a la recreación sana, se lucha por la preservación del medio ambiente y el desarrollo sostenible. Además, se ha creado un marco jurídico institucional que garantiza la plena igualdad de todos los ciudadanos con independencia de su género, color de la piel, origen nacional, creencias religiosas, condición social o cualquier otra motivación lesiva a la dignidad humana. Todos los trabajadores prácticamente están sindicalizados y protegidos por convenios colectivos, incluidos los de pequeños negocios privados. Hay representación sindical en el Consejo de Ministros y en los órganos ministeriales y corporativos. Todos estos logros han sido posibles a pesar de los obstáculos que implica el criminal bloqueo de Estados Unidos contra Cuba y todas las medidas coercitivas adicionales, unilaterales, asociadas a este, impuestas por el gobierno de Trump y mantenidas e incrementadas por el gobierno de Biden. Esto ha provocado que la población cubana viva hoy una situación especialmente difícil, que afecta el acceso a productos, servicios y medicamentos de primera necesidad. Con estas medidas intentan perjudicar las necesidades básicas del pueblo cubano para culpar al gobierno por ello, con el fin de tratar de demostrar el fracaso del socialismo e impedir que el pueblo continúe apoyando la revolución, que ha sido su objetivo desde el primer momento del triunfo de la revolución. Estados Unidos ha utilizado y utiliza también contra Cuba la subversión ideológica, inventando falsos pretextos para colocarnos en listas injustas, creando campañas en contra de nuestros médicos, en contra de nuestros líderes, en contra de los logros y acciones de la Revolución Cubana, creando además falsas víctimas y falsas violaciones de los derechos humanos para empañar la imagen de la Revolución. Ejemplo de ello han sido las recientes maniobras en el Parlamento Europeo y otros foros internacionales. En estos momentos, Cuba está sufriendo además campañas de mentiras, de manipulaciones que intentan socavar a la Revolución Cubana, que intentan culpar al gobierno cubano por las dificultades económicas en tiempos de pandemia, sin tener en cuenta las afectaciones del bloqueo, causante principal de las dificultades. Se pretende presentar a Cuba como un país colapsado y en caos para provocar un estallido social y justificar una intervención extranjera que pretenden calificar de humanitaria. En Cuba no ha habido un estallido social, como se ha pretendido mostrar al mundo. El país fue víctima de una operación político-comunicacional organizada y financiada desde el territorio estadounidense, que fracasó ante el apoyo del pueblo a la revolución, una vez más. Cuba rechaza cualquier intento o acto de sabotaje, magnicidio, otros asesinatos selectivos y aquellos que piden una intervención militar en Cuba que tendría imprevisibles consecuencias para la paz y seguridad regionales. Cuba rechaza cualquier intento o acto injerencista en sus asuntos internos. El llamado del presidente cubano y de nuestro gobierno es a solucionar las dificultades entre cubanos, sin injerencias externas y sobre la base de la unidad patriótica para avanzar en áreas que hoy están afectadas por el efecto combinado del bloqueo, la pandemia y nuestras propias dificultades que nunca hemos negado. Hoy reina la paz y la tranquilidad en Cuba y las instituciones están funcionando normalmente dentro del marco de las restricciones necesarias por la pandemia. El apoyo solidario de los amigos de Cuba ha sido muy importante durante estos 62 años de lucha, esfuerzo y sacrificio del pueblo cubano para mantener su soberanía nacional frente a las amenazas y la hostilidad de nuestro poderoso vecino. Cuba ha sido para muchas personas en el mundo un faro, un ejemplo de dignidad y de firmeza. Y es precisamente a ese ejemplo al que temen los Estados Unidos. Pero la dignidad tiene un precio. Un precio que día a día ha pagado el pueblo cubano durante estos 62 años de revolución. Ha sido una lucha permanente para construir un futuro mejor, donde siempre se ha podido contar con amigos como la Federación Sindical Mundial, defensora de la verdad y la dignidad de los pueblos. Muchas gracias.
Gracias. Muchas gracias, compañera. We as Federación Sindical Mundial, we will be stable with your efforts, with your people, with, of course, with CETESE. Comrade Pampis Kyritsis from Cyprus, you have the floor.
First of all, I would like to note how much importance is the anniversary of the foundation of WFTU and how decisive was the presence and the contribution of WFTU in the developments all over the planet, all of this year that is acting and live. This history cannot be cancelled and cannot be eliminated. It have been written in the struggles of generations of class fighters, people who inspired from the guidelines, from the principles, from the values of the class-oriented trade union movement. So, by naming the 3rd of October as International Action Day for better dignified live and working conditions, rightly I believe the leadership of WFTU is connecting the historical memory with the today's struggles for better life, for better life and working conditions. During a time when universally the pandemic of COVID prevalent, the health and the human existence, it is normal that it is the highest priority for all of us. But unfortunately, the working people are facing not only the threat of the virus, they face also the job insecurity, the unemployment, the poverty, the deterioration of the living conditions. Even in this period, the health and the human existence universally, it is at stake. The imperialistic policies, the military interventions, not only continue, but also escalate all over the world. New secret agreements, military agreements, outstandingly emerging, like recently AUKUS, which of course baked with contracts of multi-billion dollars. And of course, all of these inevitably fueling the vicious circle of the militarization. What is the picture today in the world? In the Middle East, the humanistic tragedies continues. The displacement of million people. In Palestine, instead of steps forward to the peace, to the creation of independence Palestinian state according to the decisions of United Nations, Israel, in close cooperation with United States, engaging in constant bloodbaths. And their target, of course, is to enforce by the force of the weapons the perpetuation of the occupation and finally the right of the powerful. The blockade against Cuba is continuing. And United States, they believe that by this way they can break the will and the resistance of the Cuban people. And they believe that they can make it the Cuban people to stay on their knees, something which will never happen. In my country, Cyprus, we still suffering from the consequences of the imperialistic geopolitical manifestations. The crime of 1974 against the Cyprus people with the coup d'etat of Hunda in Greece and the military invasion of Turkey, which led to the de facto division of my country and to the consolidation of the occupation and the foreign military presence still continues. The humanitarian crisis which affecting million people, the huge waves of refugees, immigrants, constitute evidence that the imperialistic policy of violence, of the open intervention, of the war, not only cannot strengthen the security and to lead the world in better days, but completely the opposite. These interventions just widening the contradictions, strengthening the hate, and finally fueling the terrorism. Even the access in secure and effective vaccines have been commodified. And not the human nature is the reason to have access in these vaccines, but the economic situation and the area in the world, someone happens to be born. It is obvious that the health crisis turning into an economic crisis and a social crisis. And like all the crises in capitalism, attempt to transfer to the shoulders of the many and weak, the many and poor, to protect the few and powerful, few and rich. The insecurity, the unemployment upset the balances and make the workers even more vulnerable to the exploitation. The procedure of the deregulation of the labor and the industrial relations is accelerating. The right to strike, the right in collective bargaining and collective agreements, the right to organize the workers, it is now in the crosshair with the pretext of the increase of the of spend because of the COVID, the social welfare is downgraded, and the class discriminations in health, in education, in culture are increasing. This is the picture we see in our country. This is what we observe in our country. And I believe that the same picture is all over Europe and all over the world. Picture which determines, I believe, all of us, which are and which have to be the priorities in which we are focusing in our daily action, in our daily strikes, for dignified life for everyone and not only for few. Paramount priority, it is of course preventing layoffs and the resistance to the deregulation of labor and industrial relations. Our resistance to the unregulated and without protection forms of employment. The fight to protect the collective bargaining and to rebelling the attack against the democratic and trade union freedoms. The demand for legislation to guarantee minimum rights to the workers in a period in which the crisis and the unemployment make the workers even more vulnerable in the exploitation. Of equal importance, it is of course the fight for a social state, welfare state, for fiscal policies which can create growth and jobs, for adequate pensions and dignified life for the pensioners, to contribute to the public health system, to be in a position to provide timely and free in a good quality care for everyone. Priority is, of course, the mobilization of the workers to protect the peace, to defend the peace, the independence and the sovereignty of the peoples against the imperialistic interventions, to the wars, the resistance to the racism and the xenophobia, and to promote the values of internationalism and humanitarian. For us, as Cypriots, it is of course priority, together with our compatriots, class-oriented Turkish Cypriot trade union, to continue and to intensify our common struggle to liberate from the foreign military presence and to reunify our country in the framework of a bi-zonal, bi-communal federation, so that we can live in peace in our common land without foreign armies and without protectors and guarantors. Finally, special priority, I believe it is the necessity of unity and solidarity among the workers, and of course unity around goals, class-oriented goals, and not goals and interests not relevant to the workers. All these struggles which we have to organize as class-oriented trade union movements, all this action we have to do these difficult times, I believe is the best honor to the 3rd of October, to the 76 years of life and action of our federation. Thank you.
Thank you, dear Comrade Pampis Kyritsis. Through your speech, you gave us a very clear picture, not only for Cyprus, but also for Europe and all over the world, because the picture is similar. Dear Cinzia, welcome from Italy. You have the floor. Okay. It is important for us to listen from Italy about our view for our International Action Day.
Okay, thank you. On behalf of USB, I am very honored to participate in these initiatives for the 76th anniversary of the foundation of the WFTU. Today, more than ever, the strengthening of our class organization is crucial for the emancipation from the exploitation of capital. The pandemic, reaping millions of victims, has highlighted the failure of the system, highlighting that the structural limits of a model of development without any rethinking by the ruling classes, who exploit the consequences of this carnage to strengthen this same model, speeding up the processes of restructuring and intensifying the class struggle from above to the detriment of the popular classes, increased inequalities, excluding any prospect of improvement. The guidelines of the European Union have dismantled all systems of social security, prevention and health care of the people for the benefit of large health insurance companies or financial companies that manage with the active participation in the various boards of directors of the financial companies, even the large trade union organized in the ITUC. Last 15 of September, the speech of the President of the European Union for the State of the Union marks a quantum leap in the ambitions of the European Union to become a major player in the global competition, even at the military level. So our perspective is harder than we are living now. In this dramatic context, today I want to tell something, especially for the condition of women, migrants and young people. And the situation in this context is extremely heavy. In the European Union, women are in the forefront and in greater numbers among the 49 million people employed in the health sector, one of the most exposed to the virus, where 76% are women. But it is not only the service and production sector in which women are subject to greater exploitation than men and to the risk associated with the pandemic, but also to the daily carnage caused by accident at work. Women are overrepresented in the essential services that remained open during the pandemic, from sales to childcare. In the European Union, women account for 82% of all trade workers and 95% of those employed in domestic and care work. Precariousness for women and young people is steadily increasing. About 84% of working women between 15 and 64 are employed in services, included those most affected by COVID crisis and suffering the most from job loss. More than 30% of women in the European Union work part-time and are largely employed in the informal economy, characterized by fewer labor rights and health protections and absence of other basic benefits. Those most affected by this drastic drop in overall GDP have therefore been women. The job loss from them is 5%, while for men is around 3% during the last year. For example, in Italy in 2020, 444,000 people lost their job. Over 70% of them are women. And also smart working is part of the so-called reconciliation policies, used as a device of protection and removal. It has institutionalized the multiplication of workloads and therefore the rate of exploitation to the advantage of the employer. The work of young people is characterized by irregular intermittent contracts with low wage and few rights. Thousands have left their country unable to access decent living conditions. Young people are finding it increasingly difficult to afford a decent education. Young women are discriminated against by wage gaps and young mothers expelled from work. They are often bicycle couriers, waiters, laborers, lifeguards, guides, actors and light and sound technicians, public utility workers. During 2020, in Italy, for example, in Europe, more than 945,000 of these kind of jobs, they lost their jobs. And the most of them are under 35 years old. So young employment has dropped by 6 to 4% to 14, around 15%. And in particular, there is a high concentration of young workers in the sectors most affected by the blockage of activity and restrictions: tourism, catering, culture and entertainment, commerce. The conditions of migrants encompassed all the worst situation of a system of exploitation and lack of rights. Tens of thousands of workers, often irregular, the most exposed to violation of their fundamental rights, are kept in unacceptable working condition and are forced to leave in order to have a job in precarious housing conditions, often at unaffordable prices and in absence of the minimum health and hygiene standards. So what we have to do, we as WFTU trade unions comrades, it is necessary that we continue, first of all, to thickening the ranks of the class union organization, to work hard on the preparation of our workers' cadre and on the various class sectors. Also in cultural items with respect to historical contradictions, such as those of women and youth, briefly exposed here. We need to launch claim platforms able to involve the new social sectors affected by the crisis, with the aim of building a social bloc able to progressively exercise hegemony around the objectives of the radical transformation of the existing society, starting from the basic needs. The right to work and the end of all discriminations against women, youth and migrants, the 35-hour week, a wage sufficient to lead a decent life, a public social welfare for all, the right to housing and a fair pension system, a taxation of large capital to find the resources needed to achieve all of these. So only struggling all together we can reach the right for a dignified life.
Thank you, dear comrade Cinzia. You have from our side our wishes for the positive result for your struggles in favor of Alitalia workers in Italy. Okay, thank you, dear comrades. It is very important that we have your speeches and your ideas in our 76th anniversary of our foundation. Of course, we will continue our struggles. And also, we want to inform our members and our friends all over the world that we are going to organize very important events also from today and day by day. Allow me to underline three of our events which will be and we are going to organize. Okay, today it is our anniversary, International Action Day. We believe that all our members and friends, they are going to organize initiatives. We will continue daily for our struggles, for the benefit of working class. And also, I want to inform our members and friends that next our international event will be 9 of October through an international symposium for the anniversary of the murder of Ernesto Che Guevara, 9 October 1967. 9 October 2021. We are going to organize international symposium through Zoom. And also the next big our and important step will be our World Trade Union Congress. 18 World Trade Union Congress, which We want to be important, open, democratic, and with class orientation. Also, we are going to organize on 29 of November international event for solidarity with Palestine. Because 29 of November, it is an important day for international solidarity with Palestinian struggle, for to have their rights to have their country with East Jerusalem as their capital. Also, next third very important our step will be our 18th World Trade Union Congress, which will be the next period, and on time we will be ready to inform all of you about the procedures of our Congress, which will be Congress open, democratic, internationalist, and with class orientation. If you have for 1 minute to give your message to our members and our friends, we have this possibility. Up to you. If you want, dear sister, you have the floor.
Muchas gracias, camarada Mavrikos. Solo quería agradecer nuevamente a la Federación Sindical Mundial por el trabajo que están haciendo con todos los trabajadores del mundo, por el apoyo solidario al pueblo de Cuba en momentos tan difíciles para nosotros. Y quería decir que, como decía el poeta, los hombres que luchan toda la vida son los imprescindibles. Y los camaradas de la Federación Sindical Mundial que han luchado toda su vida y van a seguir luchando por la dignidad y el derecho de los trabajadores son imprescindibles en un mundo como el de hoy. Y solo quería darle de nuevo muchas gracias.
Hasta la victoria siempre.
Venceremos.
Venceremos. Camarada Pampis.
What I would like to say to end my intervention is that amidst the pandemic and the crisis follows the pandemic, is that the vital role of WFTU, played by WFTU, made even clearer. WFTU unites our struggles in a global level through our common orientation, through our political and assertive framework by our collective decisions, through the cancellation of very important informations, the exchange of experience, through its actions for solidarity and internationalism, and of course through the important interventions in the great major international organizations like ILO, FAO, UNESCO, and others. And it is with satisfaction and with pride that we see that WFTU is becoming established as a stable, cohesive agent for coordination, for guidance, for practical support in our political, social, and trade union fights and struggles. 76 years are only the beginning. We have a lot of work to do for the future.
This is my message. Thank you, Pampis, Kyritsis, Cinzia.
So, the situation is very hard and harder But and our enemy is stronger today than in the past. So in each country we have a very difficult role. But and in each country we have some instruments to bring on our struggles and to change this situation for our class. One of these instruments is WFTU, is our family inside WFTU, because when the international workers' movement has changed something in the world and has changed its situation is because it was stronger and is because it has the clear knowledge of its enemy and what we have to do. So today we have this big family. Today, as class-oriented trade unions, we have the opportunity to fight all together and to bring out our struggles inside WFTU. Uniti vinceremo.
Thank you, dear comrade Cynthia. Dear WFTU members and friends all over the world, we are optimistic. We have today more than 105 million members in 133 countries. It means that there is not corner in the world without our comrades. We have our experience. We have experience, positive and negative. We know our possibilities and our weakness. Also, we have our strategy and our tactic. We have our program for the benefit of working class against exploitation, men by men, all over the world. And we are optimistic that through our struggles, because we believe that hope lies in our struggles, through our struggles, it is possible to have better today and better tomorrow for the working class, for the ordinary people all over the world. Long live 76th anniversary of World Federation of Trade Unions. Long live the international solidarity.